Gothic period was characterized by religious art with a focus on architecture. The Renaissance period, which overlaps the Gothic period in early years, is generally considered to have spanned from the late 14th century to the 17th century, and greatly expanded the scope and subject matter of art. Although these two periods have some common features, they have very different points of focus. When it comes to architecture, both of these movements can be considered as the comprehensive expression of culture in their own times. Gothic architecture started in 12th century France and lasted for 4 centuries. After that, Renaissance architecture took place from 15th century until 17th century from Florence, Italy. Different time backgrounds, social cultures, religious beliefs, and different aesthetical standards are the main reasons that form these two polar architectural styles, the Gothic and the Renaissance. Gothic architecture evolved from Romanese architecture and flourished during the late medieval period. It spread to the entire Europe, especially South and Middle Europe's architecture that are deeply influenced by this movement. With the flourishing of competition between towns around that era, society had high interest to build religious buildings. Those buildings were important because they represented wealth and pride. At that time, buildings like churches, cathedrals, abbeys were not only seen as religious architecture, they became the central key of civic lives. Many castles and even universities were built in Gothic style and remain until today. Gothic architecture represented the power of the rulers of that era. It is in the cathedrals and great churches that Gothic architecture displays its specific structures and features to the fullest. 19th century art historians and critics were astounded by the soaring heights of Gothic cathedrals, and even made notes of the extreme length of the buildings. This emphasis on verticality and light was achieved by the development of architectural features of the Gothic style. One of the defining characteristics of Gothic architecture is the pointed arc, and it is used in neo-Neo places. A vaulted shape might be called for structural or decorative consideration, like doorways, windows, arcades, or even galleries. A main characteristic of Gothic church architecture is its height, both absolute and in proportion to its size, the verticality being a metaphor to an aspiration to see heaven. A section of the main body of a Gothic church usually shows the nave as noticeably taller than its extension. One of the most universal elements of Gothic architecture is the shrinking of the walls and inserting of large windows. This expansive interior light has been a feature of Gothic cathedrals since their beginning, and this is because of the function of space in a Gothic cathedral as a function of light that is very widely used in contemporary text. The metaphysics of light in the Middle Ages led to critical belief in its divinity and the importance of its display in holy settings. Symbolism and meaning are also main characteristics. The Gothic cathedral, including the loftiness and huge dimensions of their structures, were intended to convey a theological message, the house of the great glory of God. When it comes to Renaissance architecture, its main origin reflected the rebirth of classical culture that originated in Florence in the early 15th century and spread throughout Europe, replacing the medieval Gothic style. With its development, people in that era changed their attitude and requirement of art. Gothic architecture emphasizes its verticality, but Renaissance architects paid lots of attention on symmetry and proportion and geometry of buildings. During this era, there was also a revival of ancient Roman forms, including the column and round arc, the tunnel vault, and the dome. The basic design element was the order. Knowledge of classical architecture came from the ruins of ancient buildings. As in the classical period, proportion was the most important factor of beauty. Renaissance architects found a harmony between human proportions on buildings. This concern for proportion resulted in clear, easily comprehended space and mass, which separates the Renaissance style from the more complex Gothic style. Renaissance facades are symmetrical around their vertical axis. For instance, Church facades of this period are generally surmounted by a pediment and organized by a system of pilasters. The columns and windows show a progression towards the center. One of the first true Renaissance facades was the Cathedral of Pienza. During the Renaissance, architects aimed to use columns, pilasters, and entablatures as an integrated system. One of the first buildings to use pilasters as an integrated system was the Old Sacristy by Brunelleschi. Like we said, order was key during this era. It's significant that Gothic architecture was primarily devoted to the building of religious dwellings. Renaissance architecture featured more Romanesque forms, building a home around a courtyard, for example, often based around circles instead of the vertical upward movement of Gothic architecture. And while Gothic architecture was mainly for church construction at that time, Renaissance architecture covered all forms, public and private, because it was essential to the leading art and innovation of the day. It expanded across Europe, and as those ideals spread, they replaced native forms and became the principal standard of architecture for civilized people, as they call them.